Yes. It's still.
But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean.
Keeping it real.
Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Steven and this is Steel Keeping It Real. So you know what today is.
What we're gonna do right here is go back. Way back. Back into time.
That's right, it is Throwback Thursday. And on this day, I like to showcase urban R&B, hip hop, and soul from the past on the channel. Now, this last one is another song that came out in 2001. Even though it might have been recorded or probably was recorded before then, but I don't even know how to say this. It's Michael Jackson, and the song is called Break of Dawn, and it's off of the album Invincible, which I'm going to probably put over here. It's off of the album Invincible. Now, I consider Invincible a very, very underrated album. And I like the fact that over the years, and especially now with YouTube and people doing reactions, that people are starting to appreciate the album more than they did way back in the day. And as I was going over Wikipedia and reading some of the things, all these people back in the day, you know, talked like the album was, you know, okay, it was too long and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And it's not the comeback that Michael was looking for, considering he hadn't put out an album in 6 years since Dangerous. Now, again, looking back at this, you have so many songs that, you know, now are looked upon as being great songs. You know, You Rock My World, Heaven Can Wait, Break of Dawn, Invincible, Heartbreaker, Unbreakable, Speechless, 2000 Watts, Privacy, Whatever Happens. You know, all these songs now are considered like classics. They really are. And it's just a shame, because had there not have been the controversy that happened in the 90s, which caused Michael to take a 6-year hiatus from putting out an album, but he was still writing music, and that's why I don't know exactly when this particular song was written. I just know it was written, you know, somewhere. I think they say that the songs on the album were written between 97 and 2001. So I think about Michael a lot. And as much as you see me with Prince here and over there, I have more of a connection to Michael Jackson than I do to Prince. Of course, you got to see Michael growing up as a child when I was, you know, when Michael was only like 10 years older than me, I believe. Yeah, because I was born in 69. He wasn't that much older than me at the time. No, he's older than that. I'm way off. But when when he's like on TV and I'm like 10 years old, there's still the cartoon that is out there. There's plenty of, you know, film of Michael Jackson. There's Michael Jackson being part of the Jacksons and watching the TV variety show that happened in the 70s. And then he broke off and did, you know, I Wanna Rock With You. But he had already done solo songs prior to that. And then there's you know, 1984. Why I pull up 1984? If you've ever watched any of my videos where I do songs that happen to fall into the 80s and happen to fall into 1984, 1984 was the year I got to see Michael Jackson in concert along with his brothers on the Victory Tour. And it changed my life, because here I was seeing the biggest star in the world. And granted, I was in Mile High Stadium in Denver, Colorado, and I had a nosebleed seat. But when I saw that glove twinkling on the stage, I screamed like a 13-year-old girl. And I was 14 at the time. So, you know, there's just this wave that sweeps over. And if you've ever seen Michael Jackson in concert, there's a place in your heart right there that always can go back to that. And you know what? That was a good time. You know what? I miss him. And I miss Michael Jackson. I miss Prince as well. Because Prince was still grooving, you know, right up until the day he died. And Michael was trying, I'll just leave it there, because I could talk about Michael forever. If you like videos like, oh, the video that I'm actually showing for Break of Dawn is by somebody who I have featured on my channel before, called The Beautiful Poem. And she makes, I believe it's a she, makes these videos, animated videos. It's not like it's, you know, Amblin Entertainment or Disney or anything like that. You know, they're simple, but they're animated and they're tastefully done videos of Michael Jackson. And so that's what I'm going to feature, because there's really no video for Break of Dawn. So that's what I'm going to do. If you like videos like this and others on the channel, please don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification button, because I'm doing at least 15 videos each and every week. So, without any further ado, here is Michael Jackson and Break of Dawn.
And here we go.
Stop.
All right. And see what I mean? Very simple, but tasteful and well done. And I would suggest that you guys check out the Beautiful Poem YouTube channel, because she has a lot more Michael Jackson songs and of some probably are songs you've never heard of or like, oh, wow, I haven't heard that one in a long time. There are videos like that there. But you could see that, you know, the singing, the musicianship, the production on this album are top notch. And you could see, had this been, you know, something back in the Bad era, or even the Thriller era, that are, what's before Bad, what's after Bad? Bad is the late 80s. Even if it was during that time frame, this would have been a hit song and everybody would have been playing it, and you know, it would have been enough for him to put out a video, and you know, the record company would have been behind it, and you know, it would have been, it would be as it is now, a jam. And it's just a shame. But I'll leave it at that. If you are still here, I thank you very much for staying tuned. I really do appreciate it. First and foremost, I want you guys to like the videos as much as I like making them for you. After that, all you need to do to help me out with the channel is to like, subscribe, share, and comment. Peace.